get together, the three of us, and I had this boy come out here on the front porch and take our picture one day. And we could not stand this picture, but they have used it from the dawn of time. It's the only picture they use. It keeps haunting us. And look at what you picked out. This picture. We've had so many Russ Harrington's taken. Anyway, thank you, Jason Sales, for that beautiful photo.
Jason Sales.
Shh, don't. You have to remember that we are family up here, so we know all of each other's secrets. So anyway, that was an amazing time. I loved it. And now I'm making a record, and Patsy is actually going to produce it. And we're so excited. Was a song that we wrote with Leslie Satcher, and it was called He Better Be Dead. So that was sort of the place I was in at the time, you know, man hating and stuff. But now I'm happily married, living out at the farm. I've got two little kids, and so we're writing the whole thing and just really excited about what this is gonna be like. Patsy's been listening to me sing since I was little, so she knows what sounds good and what she'll be happy to tell me what doesn't. So I'm really fired up about this project. Well, you don't need to talk about every boyfriend. Imagine how I feel. I know how you feel. I got it. She's had to step in as mama. Okay.
I'm excited to hear it. So.
Well, thank you, Michael.
You also, and we've seen how, you know, that we know that you're a great singer as well, and would love to. You know, what's going on now, and when did you start?
Whenever I first started, you know, I was raised on the road. Like, all the time I would go with my mom. My mom had her singing career, and she'd open up for my grandmother. And I would go out on stage and sing, like, a song or two songs. She'd always be like, be prepared for another one. And so I'd always sing another one. And then, but as I've gotten older, you know, I didn't really understand who she really was. And, you know, it's emotional hearing all these. I'm going to cry right now. It's emotional hearing about all these stories of my grandfather. I never got to meet him. And, like, I wish I could meet him so bad. Oh.
Stop it. Quiet enough.
I just want to meet this man.
Sweet. You will.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Taylor.
In heaven, which is
anyway. My music right now is kind of pop. It's pop, but it has country undertones underneath it, which I don't know what I would do if it wasn't for the country. And so I've got to have it. It's born in me, you know. But yeah, my influences. Memaw was a huge influence. Watching my dad, he'd get me. He's probably the most, you know, driven towards my music, and my mom. Just everyone's just. Is a reason for, you know, even Taylor Swift and all these people out here right now, you know, Justin Bieber, like, you know, oh, well, I'm gonna sound Aunt Crystal. Oh my gosh, you remember the beautiful, oh my gosh, when people would tell me that me and you looked alike, like our cheekbones, I would flip out. I didn't want to be creepy, so Aunt Crystal. But no, like, yeah. Oh, there's me right there in the center. Oh.
Last Christmas.
Yeah.
That's the gang.
That's the whole gang.
So, no, it's some of us. God, we got Philip the other side of the room.
Well, you know, my mom has, there were six children. There is 27 grandchildren and about 16 great-grandchildren. I mean, it just goes on. And when it comes time for holidays, my mom goes, let's just go somewhere. Don't call nobody.
But she never does that.
No.
There's always a huge crowd at the house.
I meet a new cousin every time I come.
At least you don't get a new brother or sister every year. But Daddy says he gave us all our old mamas.
Okay.
So fast, these stories have been so amazing. You know, for our the expectations we have are so high, this is, you know, far exceeded them. But I thought, you know, the best way to maybe finish this off was to have Emmy Rose sing a song about her grandmother. You
talk about the song that I'm about to sing. And it's called Unwinding the Strings, and I actually co-wrote it with Marla Cannon, which she's a great songwriter, so I want to give it up for Marla Cannon. Meemaw passed me down, not this guitar, but a different guitar, and it says it's the Epiphone guitar, and she wrote, "You ain't woman enough to take my man." You know, just sang all these really big songs on it, and you know, and she passed me it down. And for me, I'm an 18-year-old girl. I almost had a panic attack. Like, do you want me to have this guitar? It's just really special for me. I hope y'all like it. It's called Unwinding the Strings.
Starts with a G. When I hold it in my hands, whisper every way, woman enough to take my man, pulling me in back down an old Kentucky road. A little girl sitting on the front porch, picking, pulling out her soul. Little did she know all the secrets it was gonna hold. Starts with a G when I hold it in my hand. Yeah!
here, so.